all of this falls under the category of digital transformation. Digital transformation about our health systems is not something that can be dependent on force-fitting new technologies, whether it's blockchain or anything else, into your business. It's about rethinking the entire model and the entire ecosystem, and then using any and all of these powerful emerging technologies, blockchain, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, 3D printing, augmented reality, data analytics, robotic assistance, and so forth and so on, to implement that vision over time. Now, it's outside of our scope today to get into a detailed discussion of the digital transformation process, but I can tell you at a high level what we've found in working with our clients over the years that is still very applicable for blockchain and other emerging technologies is an approach that's referred to as third horizon planning. And to summarize it at a very high level, what third horizon planning is, it's planned and executed in three parts. One, the third horizon plan is the long-term vision of the digital enterprise or the digital environment that we anticipate finding ourselves in 3 to 5 to 7 to 10 years out. Where do we want to get to? Far enough out that we have a time cushion to overcome short-term constraints of process design, infrastructure, or application functionality of our systems. First horizon planning says, where are we today? Where do we need to go later this year? It's the typical kind of annual planning that most organizations should be going through. But with a third horizon plan in place, it tells us, you know what? Some of the things we are doing today won't need to be done in the future. We will be able to discard them entirely. Other things will be so dramatically transformed that there's no point in trying to evolve the existing versions of those processes to the new ones. But in most cases, most of those things will be able to evolve toward a radically improved digital version of how they function today when we get to that point in the future for which we're developing our third horizon vision. And those are where we want to focus most of our time and effort on evolving those processes. We probably don't want to spend a whole lot of time and effort invested into those parts of today's processes that are going to go away in the long term. And we might have to stop a little bleeding, fix a few problems here and there to make sure we keep them working. Because we want to keep the car rolling down the street while we're changing the tires. Second horizon planning fills in the missing pieces. What about those things we are going to be doing in the future, would like to, will be enabled to be doing by these emerging technologies that we are not yet doing as part of our existing operations today? That's where you set up the skunk works, if you will, the isolated processes, isolated from short-term pressures of operational issues and financial issues and so forth. So you can experiment with the new technologies like blockchain or AI. You can experiment with revised processes in a limited proof of concept kind of environment, with the objective being that over time, as those parts of the first horizon, current activities, evolve toward that vision, and the additional parts that will either replace or add to those capabilities that you're testing in your skunk works evolve eventually over that 3 to 5 to 7 year or longer horizon, they will merge together into the third horizon vision that you put in place. Now, of course, in reality, it's more complex and sophisticated than that because you're not going to lock your third horizon vision in place right now today for where you're going to be 5 years from now. So, in effect, it becomes a moving target, too. But there are ways to address that